Samuel Abujinapo is who I'm talking about. He says he's not perturbed by the voting trend of the Demangu constituency, which has not favoured the MPP parliamentary candidates in the past. Speaking on PM Express in the wake of the impending MPP primaries for the Ofan constituencies on the 28th of September, Samuel Abujinapo believes that he has what it takes to wrestle the seat from the NDC. Going for popular acclamation, the Deputy Chief of Staff is set to contest the ranking member on energy, Adam Mutuakilo.
Don't get back down with these figures, these statistics, because the statistics
should be worried.
Well, I pay attention to it, but I don't get back down with it. Okay. I don't get intimidated by them, because the statistics are derived from people's votes and people's views as to particular directions. And therefore, we are dealing with human beings. We are dealing with the constituents of Damango. And I first of all begin by saying that the people of Damango are very discerning people, very intelligent people, and they know they have a sense of direction left or right. And therefore, I am very confident and cautiously optimistic that if I put a program before them, and if I put a proposal before them, which makes sense, which resonates with them, it doesn't matter
the history,
the statistics, and the rest. I believe that I will be able to persuade them to come along with me.
Well, you heard Abujinapo there speaking to Evans Mensah yesterday on PM Express. Well, today there have been mixed reactions from some of the residents and political watchers of Demango in the Savannah region over the new Patriotic Party's choice of venue of Demango Senior High School for its scheduled parliamentary primaries in the constituency, which is going to happen this weekend. The entire preparation towards the acclamation of the Deputy Chief of Staff, Samuel Abujinapo, who is going on the post, as you're well aware of now, caught the attention of some residents with controversies following how the school has been decorated with NPP paraphernalia. Well, they believe that the venue chose is inappropriate. Let's get on the line and speak with our Savannah region correspondent, Isaac Nonya. Hello, Isaac.
Hi, GP.
Isaac, tell us a bit more about this story. This morning we heard that some of the people, NDC executives in the community have been complaining about the choice of venue.
Yeah, surely so. The regional executives think that the fact that the MPP has been allowed to move to the ground to prepare for study this program has not been fair to all the players, especially the NDC. They think that the last time that the former president arrived in the region, based on the ban that was placed on the second cycle institutions on political activities, they tested the waters to see whether that ban was working. And really, it was working. They were not given the chance to move to the venue. Hence, they chose a different environment. But this time around, they were surprised to see that the MPP was able to apply and then giving the mandate to host the program.
So the program is going to be hosted there for sure.
Come again.
So the program is going to be hosted there for sure, irrespective of the concerns that have been raised by the party executives.
Exactly.
Right. Isaac, we've run out of time. We'll get more in our subsequent bulletins. Isaac Nonya is our Savannah regional correspondent there. We'll bring you more on Joy News Prime. Right now, though, let's talk showbiz, which is how we wrap up the entire show. You can log on in the meantime to myjoyonline.com, where there's more news and information. I've carefully selected stories out there for you. Go down and get our top story, and then if you scroll all the way down on that page, you get to see our YouTube link where we stream live, and so all of our programs are there.